This was passed at the last council meeting, and now we're just looking to make appointments to the committee.
I have names, Mr. President. I have make a motion that Paul, Matt, Nate, John, Harry, David, what is that? Oh, no, all five. Do all five. Paul, make a motion that Paul, Matt, Nate be appointed to the building. Second.
Okay, we have a second. Mr. Vadney, roll call, please.
Yes.
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 John, Harry.
Second, is there a second on that?
Second.
Roll call, please.
Yes.
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 David Chamberlain, second.
Roll call.
Yes.
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 Paul Nordstrom.
Second.
Roll call.
Yes.
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 Last, I'll nominate President John Gorga to be the committee, and he's also going to be helping us. Second.
Roll call, please.
Yes.
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 Yes. Okay, now we have the five members of the committee. So we'll move on. Special by council vote of action on update on request for Main Street sidewalks. I know, Mr. Pendergast, we asked you to look into this a while ago, but I mean, I think Mr. McGee pretty much summed it up the other day.
Yes, I don't know what he summed up.
It's really not possible.
It's a state road, and then just a quick comment, it's a state road. We have no responsibility on that road. I'm sure if we took a request into DOT, they would explore it, but I think you covered that with Blackstone, I think it's not a while. I don't think it was an item back in that area, down going towards Gaines, by the water is.
It's always been narrow.
It's a tough spot down there. Maybe we could send a correspondence to DOT to maybe look at the correct and somehow identify.
There's no end there.
Nothing there.
Why waste their time with all the things going on? I wouldn't even want to waste anyone's time.
We get so many other things to send to DOT, I don't want to start.
Really, if we start going like that, we're going to waste time. And they won't get real, no more calling Wolf.
Mr. Pendergast, can I ask you a question while you're still up there? Ironstone Street?
Ironstone, yes.
Is that on your radar?
It's on my radar.
Okay. I keep corresponding with the gentleman.
It's on my radar.
Okay. Thanks.
President, just one point on the Main Street sidewalk. The other thing I think you were asked is, is there any land that the town owns along that road? And we checked that there is no. We have some near the last house on the water side coming out of Slaterville. But from there on down, it's nothing. And the piece that we own is maybe a quarter of acres. So there's no town owned public property that we create a path down.
An awkward situation for him. Moving on, discussion by council vote of other action on appointments to boards and commissions. Does anyone have an appointment that they would like to make to the assessors board of review?
Okay, we'll continue. You make a note that we'll continue that to the next meeting.
And new business? Discussion by council vote of other action on request for East Egg Hunt donation. Pendergast.
Yes. Each year we have an annual Easter egg hunt at Pacheco Park. This year is this Sunday, not Sunday, at 1 o'clock. The children, town residents, ages 2 to 8. Last year, council was very generous in helping me out with this request for the town council donation. Used to be in my operating budget box right several years ago, and it's taken out. So I'm here today to ask $700 for that donation.
So moved.
Second the discussion. Would $800, would an additional $100 help the children have a more festive event
I actually have $268 left over my donation.
Okay, so you have enough?
I have about, no, that's good.
All right.
Do we have a second on that? Any further discussion? Roll call, please.
Scott?
McGee?
Yes.
O'Hara?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. A discussion by council vote on other action and authorization for MS4 contract. Mr. Pendergast?
Yes, this is a new proposal for consulting engineering with regards to the MS4 that we have to continue. Proposal is at $9,975. It's a continuation of the current agreement that we have with the consulting engineering group for some time. I'm requesting that this money, the $9,975, comes out of contingency fund.
Yeah, we didn't have any paperwork, Brad.
Nothing in the package on this at all.
I have a question. This is just a continuance of the yearly, he's advising your department how to go in and take a look at all the storm drains and outflows to make sure everything's all right.
Right, he's already put a plan together. He's, this proposal is taking into the 2016 annual MS4 report that we have to give to DOT, and also the 2017 outfall dry weather survey can reweigh. These are all obligations that we have to do for the.
Can I make the motion?
His firm is the one that's kind of taking it together, but it's a continuation of last year's contract.
So it's gonna be every year?
I think so.
Okay.
I speak to them, I make the motion, and.
Not that I was against it, I just didn't know anything about it.
No, myself, the administrator, have had conversations about this, and I think we may reassess going forward if we continue with consulting engineering for another company, but presently, we need to get this done before the end of April, so.
So we have a motion.
Question? Mr. Clary, the source of the funds rate that you're recommending?
The contingency fund.
Council's contingency.
The council's contingency.
What, can we give you some from?
Okay, we have a motion and a second, am I correct?
If we had a total, we'd have.
That's right.
Mr. Halloran?
Yes.
Mr. McGee?
Yes.
O'Hara?
Yes.
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 Tony, if we had let it go back, I hear you can spend.
Discussion by council vote on other action on resolution regarding the hotel tax, Blackstone Valley Tourism Council. This is what we talked about earlier, right?
Yes, this is a resolution, Mr. President, that was included in the package. The clerk's office already put a town council form, so if you support it, it's a proper form that.
It's a proper form?
It's a proper form that.
I've got a motion, certainly want to support.
I agree. Joanne, you have?
Blackstone Valley Tourism Council.
Do you have the original for us to sign with?
Yes.
It's an extra.
I will, yeah.
It's an extra.
Joanne, you have a phone? I've got a question. Mr. President, I would like to make a motion to support Blackstone Valley Tourism Council's resolution asking the General Assembly to keep intact the current regional hotel tax formula of 47% of hotel tax received from our valley hotels go to the Blackstone Valley Tourism Council. That's my motion.
Second.
Any further discussion?
Scott?
Yes.
McGee?
Yes.
O'Hara?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Discussion by council vote on other action on resolution regarding tax exempt status for nonprofit hospitals. Mr. Zwolenski?
Mr. President, as you know, there's a House Bill H5779 and a Senate Bill S0461. This is in response to Landmark Medical Center, which is considering converting to a nonprofit. As we all know, when it was a profitable institute, the town of North Smithfield, as well as the city of Woonsocket, received some tax revenue. I called Senator Newberry's office earlier this morning, I spoke to one of his administrative staff. As we all know, this was referred to the House Finance on March 1st, and it's awaiting a hearing. So we're joining sister city Woonsocket, Barrowville, and the reps that, from those communities in requesting that this House bill and Senate bill get passed so that the local communities can decide if they wish to have a pilot program for the hospital. So I would like to make a motion that hopefully everybody's had time to read it and digest it. Hopefully I'm going to make a motion we accept this and send this to Mr. Newberry or whomever it goes to in the state.
Is there a second on that?
Yeah, second.
Alan? Any further discussion?
Roll call.
Mr. Halloran?
Yes.
McGee?
Yes.
Carol?
Yes.
Zwolenski?
Yes.
Mayor Carter?
Yes. Discussion by council vote on other action on resolution regarding a traffic enforcement detail. This is sponsored by myself and Mr. Zwolenski. We have had a lot of residents calling from all different parts of town requesting police visibility. There's a grant right now that would allow for a overtime. This is what we're trying to do, is create an overtime position. That the police would work the overtime position, and hopefully the money that they raise in traffic fines would be enough to offset the cost of the detail. And then, so therefore, this would be like a perpetual fund that they would, and then we would have an extra officer on the road. And it's also an opportunity for them as an overtime detail for the police, but more importantly, for the citizens, that they would create an extra officer on the road that's dedicated just to traffic enforcement. He won't be handling calls, but of course, his first priority will be to back up any police officers that need assistance. But that aside, his main priority would be to go out there, his or her main priority would be to go out there and issue motor vehicle violations.
Question on that. I'm for it, but I hate to use this expression. We're not going to go south. You go drive through the south.
Oh. Yeah. No, there's enough complaints in town that I think that. It seems that every street, there's somebody on every street that has an issue with speeding on their street. So this is an attempt to try to alleviate that. The long-term plan, I think, would be to have a special division on the police dedicated to just traffic. But that's, right now, that's a manpower issue. I mean, I'd like to see a commercial enforcement unit on the police department, too. If they could. But that's down the road. But this is the first step in creating, trying to do something about the complaints.
I just don't know if they'll stay with it, you know what I mean?
Well, it's an opportunity for them as an overtime detail.
Yeah, I don't know. I just don't trust that it will stay that way.
And as a result of that, we made this a pilot program, so if it's for 1 year. So if it's not working out in 1 year, if they're not fulfilling their end of the deal where they're filling the detail and paying for itself, then we'll just shut the program down. And we can check
with pilot.
It's a pilot, and we can check with the finance office at any time to find out if it's funding itself.
Well, like I say, I still am worried about when you go through other towns, you're really going to be wrong. You know what I mean? I don't know if we want to be that type of town. You know, I know what you're saying.
So, like myself.
Yeah. So I'm a little worried about that too.
But we've had enough complaints, I think, about speeding in town to justify it.
Yeah, if I may, Mr. President, I think I have one concern is the safety of our residents, the people that, from other communities that use our roads, more importantly, our school children. you actually take your life in your hand when you're around the high school and the middle school over there. It's upsetting to see how fast the cars travel and passing each other. So I think that this will be a self-funding. And distinguished colleague to my right, it says going south. Yeah, but they know how to drive down south, and they respect the law. And you know what? Someone said, I think,
that's what you should ask.
Yeah, well, you know what? I would rather have people complain about being stopped than having some child end up in
Absolutely.
Hasbro Hospital, so whatever it takes, we're going to attempt to slow this down.
Is there a motion, Mr. President?
It will be only 1 year, and then we vote again.
But it'll be a pilot program for 1 year. And we'll, then we'll be able to reassess after a year to see if it's working.
We'll know every month anyway, Mr. President, because the police chief said this is required. So we'll have that on a regular monthly basis after the program.
Well, and also, if we, if the police are trying to conduct
speed enforcement.
And say in front of the middle school or the elementary school, we're not taking away from a detail, I mean, a duty officer to go do that. Now, it's going to be someone that's specifically assigned to traffic enforcement. And it's on them, if they don't work the detail, then we'll shut it down.
I would say this to you, Mr. President, and I don't have to tell you, the Rhode Island State Police make a lot of drug cases. Five traffic stops, am I right?
Yes.
And so, you know, things are going to happen if you're up there on the highways. I think that you're looking at, you know, today you're looking at secondary roads, town roads, and maybe you think direct attention to that, that might alleviate the security concern. But there's no more discussion on this.
Well, you know, you actually make a very good point. I might have looked over was, we don't, this is not for the officer to go up on the highway and get tickets.
No, it's not, it's state roads within town, not 146.
Exactly, right.
This is going to be.
Oh, I understand.
Right.
St. Paul Street, over five.
Yeah, 102, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Old Smithfield Road.
Do I have a second? Yeah, the resolution is in your packet, that I'm sure you're voting on, so.
Call the question.
I want to entertain a motion to.
Yes, I made the motion.
I second.
Any further discussion?
Is that the decision?
Sorry, Brian, sorry. We've had a motion, we had a second, so we have to call the vote. I'm sorry to exclude you, but Robert's rules. I would make a motion to let Brian speak, if everybody's okay with that.
Yes.
Let it go on the record that we follow the procedure.
Yeah, but if he talks, then everybody's going to want to talk.
Yeah.
I'm just curious if that position's going to be, not necessarily, well, to turn up and confirm that, like after a year, I mean, is that person going to be?
It's not a one person, it's a detail that's available to all the officers. So hopefully they work out some kind of a list where it's distributed, it's fairly among the officers.
So someone's not going to be hiding the action?
No.
It's going to be a rotational thing?
It's going to be a rotation.
And Brian, you might be thinking about Fast Cop, there's a program about maybe 20 years ago where the feds gave local communities money, 1 or 2 years to bring in new police officers. But at the end of that, you know, 1 or 2 years, the town had to pick it up.
You pay $10,000, the town pay $10,000, and after those 3 years, then the community picked up the whole pack.
Okay, so.
And they're saying pilot, and we're going to look at it every month to see what happens. The key word is pilot. All right?
There is, you know, another aspect of this that I would be watching from a certain sense that I agree with some of the concerns. I think it's a good idea that, as I said to so many people, the biggest number of complaints that I've received since I started in December is about traffic. So there is a concern. I don't see anything in this that encourages a certain sense we're hiring another officer. That's not what this is at all. I will be watching also to make sure that we don't have this burden being put on one person.
It's a detail list,
right?
And people sign up for it.
Yeah, the overtime circumstance though tends to be, you know, gravitated to a small number, and I get concerned about people being ready on their regular shift. So that is another aspect of it. I think we look at and make sure it does work and it does rotate. It's not, you know,
that's on them to police their own. Have a second, am I correct?
Sure, a second.
Okay, rolling.
Ms. Halloran?
Yes.
Ms. Rickey?
Yes.
Ms. O'Hara?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes.